my name is Shauna, in case you don't know, and welcome back to another video. My voice is like hoarse today, and I'm not really sure why. And also this eye, you can't really tell very well in the video, but it's like freaking out today, so I don't really know what my body is doing. But anyways, today I will be doing the stay-at-home book tag. I believe this was created by Paperback Princess, and I will link their channel down in the description below. I'm doing this tag today because I keep seeing an increase of people just like casually like hanging out with their friends and going to parties and posting about it and like going on vacations, and I'm like, hey, we're still in the middle of a pandemic. Just because you want the pandemic to be over doesn't mean that it's actually over, because it's literally not over at all. So to start off, the first prompt is laying in bed. A book that you could slash have read in a day. Let me go find one really quickly. I'm gonna be running around to find books in this video, so hopefully the lighting doesn't get too messed up whenever I come back. A book that I have read in one day is Harry Potter and the Philosopher's Stone. I attempted to join like this readathon thing where they were rereading Philosopher's Stone in the summer that I went to Europe, and I managed to read Philosopher's Stone in one day. But then I sort of like failed all the rest of the readathon because I went on my Europe trip. But yeah, I have read this book in one day. I really want to read the illustrated edition, so maybe I'll read it again, but I've already read this book twice this year, so I don't know. Maybe I should read some of the ones later in the series that I haven't read this year. I don't know though. But yeah, I have been able to read this one in one day before. It's really easy to read it in one day because the pacing is just really fast, and it is sort of longish. 332 pages. But if you set your mind to it and you like the pacing of the story, you can read it really quickly. Snacking, a guilty pleasure book. I know that most people who have guilty pleasure books normally like count them as like eroticas and stuff, but I'm not really about that. For me, a guilty pleasure book is like a book that I feel like I shouldn't be reading because of my age level and because of what other people my age in general are like reading. So that's sort of what I classify as a guilty pleasure book, not so much like naughty books or whatever you want to call them. So yeah, let me go find a book that I'm like slightly embarrassed that I've read but that I actually really enjoyed. For me, that's mostly kids books because I feel like I'm 19 and I shouldn't be reading kids books yet. Here I am and I'm still reading kids books a lot. Okay, so a kids book that I read recently that I really enjoyed was The Light of Meridian, which is the seventh book in the Witch series. It is like on my bucket list to read all of the books in the Witch series. I love the graphic novels when I was younger, and I just never finished reading the chapter books. I started reading them when I was younger, but I never finished them. So yeah, I really enjoyed this one. In case you don't know, Witch is about these five girls that like find out that they're like these guardians of the veil. So they have like these superpower things. They turn into like these fairy creatures when they get their powers activated. As you can see, they have these really cool costumes, and that probably contributed to why I liked the series when I was younger. And four of the girls have elemental magic or elemental control, and the fifth one is the leader, and she has like the heart of Kandor, which you'll find out more about that if you read the series. It's a really good series, and I feel like you don't have to be a kid to enjoy the series because it is really good. I know that's also a TV show, and I found all of the episodes on YouTube, so maybe I'll binge watch that soon. Netflix, a series you want to start. I'm just gonna go grab the first book in the series, so I'll be right back. So I want to start reading the Fifth Wave series by Rick Yancey. I'm not gonna lie, the reason why I haven't read this yet is because I'm intimidated by its size. It's like really thick. How many pages long is it? It's 457 pages long, so it's really thick. But I really want to read this series because I really enjoyed the movie, and I want to find out what happens next in the series because we obviously didn't get a sequel to the first movie. And also, I read a different like alien invasion story recently and I really enjoyed it, so I think I will really enjoy this one when I get around to reading it. Another reason why I haven't read this book yet is because before I start another series, I'm trying to convince myself to finish reading the series that I've already started, which will take me a while, but like, I just feel like I need to do that because I have like 10 series or so that I haven't finished yet that I own the rest of the books in the series or that I really enjoyed the first book, so I don't know. Maybe I'll get around to reading this soon. I'll just have to see what I feel like doing. Next up is Deep Clean, a book that's been on your TBR for ages. I have a lot of books I could choose for this. A book that's been on my TBR for ages is The Evolution of Calpurnia Tate by Jacqueline Kelly. I got this book when I was in elementary school, so clearly it's been on my TBR for a long time because I'm now in college and I still haven't read it. For anyone who's interested in this book, I'm gonna read the back of the book for you to see what it's about. The summer of 1899 is hot in Calpurnia's sleepy Texas town, and there aren't a lot of good ways to stay cool. Her mother has a new wind machine from town, but Callie might just have to resort to stealthily cutting off her hair one sneaky inch at a time. She also spends a lot of time at the river with her grandfather, an avid naturalist. It turns out that every drop of river water is teeming with life. All you have to do is look through a microscope. As Callie explores the natural world around her, she develops a close relationship with her grandfather, navigates dangers of living with six brothers, and learns just what it means to be a girl at the turn of the century. So yeah, this book seemed interesting and someone recommended it to me when I was in elementary school, so I got it, but I had never read it. Next up is Animal Crossing, a book you bought recently because of the hype. So I haven't really been buying books recently because of the hype, I don't think. Have I? I don't know. I feel like I've been buying less books now that it's in quarantine, but let me go find one that I got because of the hype. So I think I bought Throne of Glass recently-ish, like before quarantine started, so I'm choosing this one for that. This book just seems really interesting, and hopefully I'll enjoy it when I get around to reading it. But this series I think is really long, so it's going to be a huge commitment to start reading this series. Productivity, a book you learned or had an impact on you. For me, that is Dear Martin by Nick Stone. Dear Martin had some conversations about race and racism that I feel like were really important to read and understand, and it opened my eyes a little bit more on racism. And I'm not the hugest fan of the way that the book was written, but it did have an impact on me and it taught me a lot of stuff about racism. Facetime, a book you were gifted. The book that I was gifted was Warcross by Mary Lou. I was given this at Christmas last year by my grandparents. I haven't gotten around to reading it yet, but it seems really interesting and it's by one of my favorite authors of all time, so hopefully I'll read it soon. I think it's also a duology, so it's less of a big commitment to read this one than a longer series. Sorry that I keep like repositioning and stuff. There's a light shining in my room like really strong right now, as you can see, and I'm trying to like avoid shadows and bright lights on my skin, but I'm sort of failing at this. Self-care. What is one thing you have done recently to look after yourself? I have been staying on top of drinking water. I've been playing video games with my brother, and that's been fun. It sort of gets me to talk to other people because I live by myself, and also video games are just a nice distraction and relief. Did you just see my cat jump in my closet? Oh my gosh. I keep trying to get her to not go in there because the first day I moved into my apartment and let her in here, she immediately went into my closet and tried to pee in a hat. So I should probably get her out soon. The final prompt is bonus. Name a book coming out soon. The only one I can think of that's coming out soon will probably be out by the time that this video is uploaded, and that is Set Fire to the Gods by Kristen Simmons and Sarah Rash. I think you all know by now that I love Kristen Simmons and I'll support everything that Kristen Simmons writes, so I already pre-ordered that one of course, and hopefully it is really really good. So that's all for the tag. I really hope you enjoyed this video. As I said at the start of the video, the tag creator will be linked down in the description below. All of the questions will also be down in the description below in case you want to do this tag yourself. I feel like I need to go because I keep hearing banging on my front door. It's really weird. Anyways, if you like this video, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe to me if you haven't already, and I will see all of you in my next video. Bye!